Leighton Strachey never fails to entertain me with his wit and candour, and this is most certainly the case with Ermyntrude and Esmeralda. And I have to say, I hope I'm pronouncing Ermyntrude correctly. It's not a name I've ever heard of. This is a short story. I think it's described as a novel, but it's not a novel. Certainly, it's a work of fiction by Strachey. And I've read this in the most beautiful edition. This is an edition with an introduction by Michael Holroyd with illustrations by Arte, published by Anthony Blonde, and it is a beautiful edition. So if you're interested in reading this and you don't know which edition to go for, this is perfect. So basically, this is written as an epistolary, two correspondents writing letters to one another. And it's all about them trying to discover what sex is. And the most exciting part is that he finished writing this in his home in Belsize Park Gardens, which is right next to where I live in Belsize Park. So that's just an aside that made me very happy. But in this, the two girls who we now know are called Esmeralda and Ermyntrude. Somebody please correct me if that's not right. They're 17-year-old girls, and they start talking to each other about sex and wondering what castration is. And then the letters get more and more in-depth as they learn until the climax, which I will not divulge. But I will say that this is pretty hysterically written. It's not a massive, massive book. I don't know how many pages it would be, because this is quite a large illustrated edition. There's quite a nice description of what this actually is from Holroyd in the introduction. It says here, yeah, so I'll read this bit. Ermyntrude and Esmeralda was written as an exchange of correspondence between two upper-class 17-year-old girls who have pledged themselves to find out all they can about the manifold mysteries of sex and report their discoveries to each other by letter. And straight away, there's a comment here that this is nothing like what Strachey would have ever written before. But when you look at Eminent Victorians and the subject matter and the way in which he is handling this, it is kind of just another outlet for him to explore these avenues and to express his thoughts and opinions, I guess, through wit. And this way it's done in fiction, which I think is certainly a very unique approach for Strachey in this context. It's thoroughly enjoyable. The language is not child-friendly, as I'm sure you can imagine. They refer to them as, well, let's just say I can't say it, I will get demonetized if YouTube picks up what they call female genitalia, but it's the other word for cat, pretty ordinary. But they refer to the penis as a bow wow, and I've never heard of that before. As a bow wow. Great word to say, but not a word I'd heard used in that context. So it's pretty interesting. There's a hilarious bit where she's looking up castration in the dictionary, and she just goes round and round in circles, and their naivety is so entertaining to read about. When we get to kind of the climax, the end of the book, there's a really vivid description, and some people have kind of described this as being like weird Victorian porn. It's not that bad at all. It's certainly not as strong as 50 Shades of Grey, but I still think if this were published now, it would probably be in the erotica section. But it's not as bad as what one might expect. But certainly the language is hysterical, the naivety of the girls is brilliant. I mean, they're 17. You'd think they'd know a bit more by then, but they are slightly wealthy and, you know, kept away from the lower classes who may have openly talked about this kind of thing more frequently. It's brilliant. It's good fun. It's not an innovative, life-changing book. But if you want to read Strachey's wonderful writing quality and his beautiful wit and humour and the way he handles this topic, almost, I don't want to say sarcastically, but there's almost an irony in the way that it's done. I absolutely adore it. It's wonderful to read. There's a bit about homosexuality, and because the girls don't understand sex, they don't think there's anything wrong with that homosexuality, despite Victorian sensibilities. So I think there's actually a really nice message in this as well. But honestly, it's brilliant. Definitely get your hands on a copy. You might be able to read it online. If I can find a version online, I will link it in the description. But Ermintrude and Esmeralda by Listen Strachey is a fantastic way to spend half an hour.